Hey Charles, welcome back.
Yeah. Well, it's been a while.
Take your book. Congratulations on your publication.
Yes, well, where is it now?
Look around.
Look at it, ladies and gentlemen. Get it. Of course, I...
10 years later.
10 years later, it's a fact. Can you open it? I'm not so good at opening things. It's like presents, you see. And I'm sorry you had to wait for about 10 years, all of you, to read it. But it's also, the last part of the book is a little bit about...
Dangerous minds.
Dangerous minds. It's a time-like sketches of a dangerous mind. It's about mind control. And that's what you want to talk about, isn't it?
Yeah, my next book will be exposing psychiatry and the links to mind control, the CIA, and how they try to make people think that they're insane, but, well, in fact, there is nothing wrong with them.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And also want to thank, with this book, can I thank some? Yes. I want to thank Kiso for having it beautifully done. No photos on it, but in the inside, beautiful photographs of Danny Quintelier. Thank you, Danny.
And something I want to talk, we can talk openly, right?
We can talk openly, okay. Right? But
I want to thank you for your present, a note to your grandfather.
Yes, Freemason.
Yes, because a Freemason might think that I'm against them, but it's not, because I just don't want a fascist control system.
We do not want fascism coming back, no, we don't.
No. So next week I will have the CD by Freestone.
And, yes, that's your present. Yeah, present. That's the least thing I can do for you, man.
So people from the Vatican who are watching my website make Freemasonry and the Christian religion unite better.
Everything's got to unite now.
Yes, because there is only one church and it's in the heart.
Yes, in the heart. Every religion is one. Mm-hmm. One.
Voila. And this is my book, I'm also proud
of it. Yes, beautiful book.
And then the next book, yeah, must be written, but I'm doing the research now and it's fucking heavy.
Yeah, well, I mean, you've been there, I've been there. We're open-minded, but sometimes, you got to try to close your mind. Don't let them read into your mind. That's the trick. How do you short-circuit control? That was also in the Burroughs, William Burroughs thing I told you about. Huh?
Yeah.
The man within, about the life of William Burroughs. Mm-hmm. And he told the person, I can't remember the name anymore, but about, how do you short-circuit control? Which is that, if I could say damn difficult. But
do you believe in conspiracies?
Conspiracies, yes, I do, because, listen, people, Jimi Hendrix was going to fire his manager, and shortly after he tells his manager this, he dies with
no coincidence.
Wine in his lungs. Now, to my thoughts, you do not breathe wine. He took so much micrograms of LSD before he did a concert, but the most beautiful thing that he left behind, he never got a cent for it, but he spent his money on something that still exists, the Electric Lady Studios in New York. Jimi Hendrix studio that he is still in his name.
Subject I want to touch now. Yeah. David Icke.
Yes.
He's warning very against a fascist global dictatorship. Yes. And we're moving to Ireland.
Yeah, we're moving to Ireland.
We had enough of the EU.
Yes, yes. Well, I thought, can I make a little bit of an advertisement for a record store?
Yes.
I got, I thought it was important to record and to give my gratitude to Belgium and especially Antwerp for letting me record my last album not my last album in Belgium. I'll come back and record you, but we move on. The next thing is I will be doing the guitar parts on a single of my man here.
Yes.
in Mechelen.
Madeline song and Awakenings.
Yeah, and Awakenings. And then my thought was to make the band, not Bob Dylan's band, but the band with two ends. Now, if you hear this, see this, or whatever, do not immediately put, we're the band, because I got that covered. And I'll just put band and some other letters behind it, okay? So, anyway, and Christo won't always be able to be in the band, but he's, honorary member of the band.
Okay. But I will have a tight schedule because I'm doing volunteers work soon. I'm now volunteering with Bart, my mentor.
Okay. Yeah, he does yoga, all things.
Yes. Yeah. Normally I may not drink, but Michael said from time to time you may relax a little bit now.
And now we can.
But normally I'm pretty sober. But
well, this Saturday is the debut of Coffee and Vinyl. A little bit of name dropping, but I have to. Steph Camille Carlins is showcasing his solo album, his first solo vinyl, and of course probably on CD as well. My album is now only available on vinyl, people.
And Myself on Tilt.
He couldn't do the, you know, the closing, so they put me on the closing. But it's not like a festival, you know, it's just everybody is equal. I always saw as everybody is equal. I mean, you got this choice, this person likes that, this person likes that. But please, people, just stick around, listen to everything. I'm not bringing all the albums with me. I mean, it's 500, but 500 is pretty much, you know. It's, yeah.
And then this summer we will be 3 days in the studio.
3 days in the studio.
In Mechelen. You have a phone. Okay.
Oh, that's it. Okay.
We stop it here. Bye.
Bye.
Peace.